Cost-efficient online hyperparameter optimization. In this work, we introduce a novel Bayesian optimization with a costly feedback setting and a cost-efficient algorithm for online hyperparameter optimization. It is well known that training deep neural networks involves a large number of hyperparameters, and many of them are found through repetitive trial and error. Online hyperparameter optimization, or HPO, could potentially save a lot of time compared to grid search procedures performed in nested loops. However, repetitive experiments on the order of hundreds of evaluations are still required, which makes HPO expensive. Recent advances in meta-learning shows that we can tune the hyperparameters online together with the parameters of the original network by constantly evaluating on a held-out validation set. While this means that the training job only needs to be launched once, the cost of each training step rises sharply. To learn the hyperparameters, one has to take a gradient step from the reward signals obtained by evaluating on a separate set of validation examples to the hyperparameters. Depending on the size of the validation set, this can make the training time several times longer. For instance, in the learning to reweight framework, doing a one-step approximation makes the algorithm three times expensive in computation. As a consequence, we want to make an online HPO efficient in the evaluation cost. To address this problem, we propose to model the online HPO as a time-varying Bayesian optimization problem with costly feedback. Compared to the conventional setting, it requires the agent to pay a cost whenever it decides to query the unknown objective function. At each round, the agent selects the hyperparameter configurations to sequentially maximize the reward signals. Since the reward feedback is obtained through evaluation on the validation set, which is usually expensive, the agent is allowed to skip the evaluation or pay a certain computation cost to see the reward. More specifically, the detailed formulation is given in this slide. We want to specifically optimize an unknown objective function. At each iteration, the agent picks one position, xt. After selecting the point, it has an option to decide whether to query the feedback, yt. If it decides to see the reward, then it receives a noisy observation and a cost is required to be paid. The observation set Sn contains all the xy pairs and records the time steps for observing the data. To measure the performance of algorithms, we define the regret and the cost. For simplicity, we consider the instantaneous cost is equal to 1 if the agent decides to receive the feedback. Otherwise, it's 0. In practice, we want the regret and the cost to both be small. So the final loss is defined as the sum of the cumulative regret and cost. Since the reward signals for online HPO vary as the learning proceeds, and similar hyperparameter configurations usually lead to similar performance, we consider using a time-varying Gaussian process, or GP, to model the underlying objective function. Standard GP-UCB algorithms will lead to a linear cumulative cost on a costly feedback setting, as it requires the feedback every step. As a response, we propose a cost-efficient query strategy to decide whether to receive the feedback every round. The general idea is that we want to keep the most informative queries, but skip those that are uninformative. Compared to GP-UCB, we leverage a relative magnitude to characterize the progress of the GP model. We give our cost-efficient query rule in the red box. The agent will only receive the feedback when it is less confident in distinguishing the best candidate, where the kappa controls the confidence threshold for the query. More specifically, if the posterior predictive estimation of the best candidate is greater than the posterior predictive estimation of any other candidates with high probability, the agent will skip the query. In other words, if the agent is pretty confident that the current decision will lead to minor regret, it will not receive the feedback to save the query cost. We thoroughly evaluate the proposed algorithm on both synthetic data and practical online HPO problems. First, we evaluate two variants of the CE-GP-UCB onto synthetic data. Specifically, we consider the finite arm banded setting where each arm is assumed independent, where the k-space is equal to L, and the BO setting where the candidates are correlated, where the k-space is equal to SE or the Matern kernels. For the banded setting, three different kinds of time-varying functions are considered: sine, Gaussian, and piecewise, shown in the above figures. We compare our algorithm with other time-varying banded algorithms and the GPC-UCB with a Bernoulli sampling strategy. Compared to the baselines, our cost-effective GPUCB achieves similar average regret while requiring less queries consistently under the three types of time-varying functions. We further visualize how GP models evolve with time increasing. From the video, we can find that the GP model becomes less confident and has a large uncertainty when no feedback is received for a long time. But when the agent cannot distinguish the three arms, it will query the feedback and update the GP model. We also consider another synthetic dataset where the candidates are correlated. In this setting, we follow the previous time-varying GPUCB assumptions and use a transition function to model the variation of function. The epsilon denotes the forgetting rate that controls the variation of the unknown functions. The larger the epsilon is, the faster the function will change. The figure shows the trade-off curves between the average regret and query cost for different algorithms. The performance is averaged over 50 independent trials. We observe that our method suffers from a minor regret loss when using 50% query cost, whereas the other baselines with Bernoulli strategy lead to a larger performance loss. For better understanding of how the proposed cost-efficient query rule works, we visualize the GP models for the time-varying GPUCB with full observations and our cost-effective GPUCB. Here, the purple points denote the GP model receives the feedback, and the green points denote the GP model skipping the query. The blue line is the ground truth objective, and the dashed line is the dashed red line is the posterior mean. The gray area denotes the confidence area. From the video, we know the proposed method is able to save queries significantly while maintaining similar performance. Moreover, the CEGPUCB only skips the query when the candidates are close to the optimal point, thus leading to minor regret. Finally, we verify the effectiveness of our proposed algorithm on two challenging deep learning applications. Self-tuning networks, or STN, is an online algorithm that uses a hypernetwork to approximate an inner loop of the bi-level optimization. Standard STN tunes hyperparameters, such as dropout, wave decay, and data augmentation, by alternating the following two steps: a training phase, where you train one mini-batch data on the training set, and a tuning phase, where you evaluate one mini-batch data on the held-out validation set, and then backpropagate the gradients through the hypernetwork to update the hyperparameters. However, it's expensive to evaluate densely since evaluation and taking gradients are expensive. Moreover, it is not optimal to tune all the time due to the biases of one mini-batch validation. We also find the tuning schedule plays a significant role when applying self-tuning networks to larger networks. To adjust the tuning schedule with the learning process, we model STN as a two-arm bandit problem, where the two arms are training only and tuning and training. Then the query cost is a validation on the whole validation set. We apply our algorithm in this setting to decide whether or not STN should query the validation set and tune the hyperparameter. Compared to the baselines, we can achieve better performance with affordable searching time. Finally, we evaluate our method on tuning data augmentations in unsupervised contrastive learning. The goal of unsupervised learning is to learn meaningful representations directly from unlabeled data, since acquiring annotations is expensive. SimClear is a state-of-the-art approach that learns representations by maximizing agreement between differently augmented views of the same data example. It's shown in the original paper that the type of data augmentations are critical in learning meaningful representations. In this paper, we follow the original setting and consider eight data augmentations shown in the figure. Researchers conducted extensive ablation studies on the data augmentations. By contrast, we aim to apply the cost-effective GPUCB in tuning the probability of randomly applying eight common data augmentations. Similar to STN, we define the accuracy gain on the validation set as the cost of feedback, since training one linear readout layer on the validation set from scratch is expensive. We show that with 1.6 times regular training time, we can achieve similar performance compared to baselines that have been extensively tuned by human experts. This is the introduction for this submission. Thank you very much.